When people experience burnout, they usually assume it's because they're doing way too much. But have you ever thought about the flip side? Is it possible that you're feeling burnt out because you're not doing enough things that actually make you feel alive, not making time for the things that truly matter to your overall happiness and well-being? Today, we're diving deep into that flip side to talk about 10 reasons you're feeling burnt out and what you can do about it. Number 1. You suck at setting boundaries. Are you the kind of person who can't say no? Being a people pleaser is a major cause for burnout, and believe it or not, it usually starts somewhere in our childhood. Kids who grew up with less than unconditional love often have a hard time turning people down or saying no, even when it's something they don't want to do. This leads to way too many commitments and spreading yourself so thin you could shatter into a million pieces at any moment. For this, it's important to retrain your mind to understand you can't pour from an empty cup. Saying no and setting boundaries isn't jilting others, it's an act of self-love. Practice it enough and it'll become second nature. And Aluxers, if you stick with us until the end, we'll give you a little anti-burnout hack that could help you fall asleep in just a few minutes. Number 2. Doing work you don't care about. Look, it's kinda unrealistic to think that every human being will end up working a job or landing a career they absolutely love all the time. But there is a difference between loving what you do and caring about what you do. No matter what, there will always be aspects of our work we don't necessarily enjoy, but if you find yourself hating every little thing, it's time to reassess. What is it that bothers you the most? Is there a person you can hash out your problems with to brainstorm solutions? Is there a mindset shift you need to work on to be less negative? Because sometimes it really is a frame of mind thing. However, if you hit a point where you feel zero value in the work that you do, well, it's time to take control of the situation and change up how you make a living, or else this reason for burnout ain't going anywhere. Number 3. All work and no play. These are the folks who wear their burnout like a badge of honor. The ones who think busy equals successful. The ones who will never be happy. There may not be such a thing as a work-life balance, but there is such a thing as a balanced life. And you better believe it involves play. Yes, it's important to be disciplined about your work, but many high achievers forget to be disciplined about allowing themselves to kick back and just be silly. Be reminded of the kid they once were and get in touch with them for a little while. Easier said than done, we know, but as humans, we are our habits. So work on making a habit out of including some play in every day and it'll keep the burnout at bay. Alright, enough with the rhyming, let's move on. Number 4. You're not making time for your friends. This one kind of ties in with the previous point, all work and no play. Look, humans are social creatures. If you deprive yourself for long enough, feelings of burnout are almost inevitable. It's important to cultivate those bonds with a select few people in life, the ones who understand you, make you feel seen and cared for, the ones you can share your true self without fear of judgment. If you're in a place where you don't currently have those kinds of people, the good news is there's more than 7 billion people on this planet and guaranteed your tribe is out there. A good place to start is in the comments section below. Right away, you have something to bond over. You're both Aluxers. Number 5. You're a perfectionist. This is a tricky one because it's always rooted somewhere deep inside our minds. People who lead with their perfectionist tendencies usually have a deep-seated fear of getting it wrong or disappointing others. In their eyes, nothing they do is ever good enough. Like anything related to personality, the first step is to recognize what's going on and get mindful about it, because true perfectionism can lead to a whole host of badness, like extreme procrastination, chronic stress, depression, and tragically even suicide. If you notice yourself in the rut of perfectionism, take that as a cue to check in with yourself. What are you feeling? What triggered those feelings? Get to work on creating new ways to cope with them. It's not going to be an overnight quick fix. It took us a lifetime to become this way. It's going to take some time and effort to retrain the mind. And if you need some help in that department, don't worry, because we got you. Head to Alux.com/meditation and join the thousands of people who've already taken control of their minds through our premium course called Mind Mastery. It teaches you meditation and mindfulness like you've never experienced than before. Number 6. You're a Debbie Downer. You know those people who can look at literally any situation and list off at least a dozen negative things about it? Yeah, those guys are burning out. It sounds kinda wishy-washy, but there's a upload of power and positive thoughts and affirmations. They quite literally can rewire your brain to be more optimistic and positive. The trick is you have to do it consistently, even when it feels stupid or you don't believe the words coming out of your own mouth. Just say them anyway. Be mindful of your negative thoughts and try to counter them in real time. Keeping a gratitude journal might seem cliche at this point, but it's another great tool to help retrain the mind to see the positives. Do it every day and you'll notice the shift inside within weeks. Number 7. You're unable to delegate. Letting go of the need for control is tough, right? But not doing it is a surefire way to burn yourself out. There isn't a person in this world who can do everything themselves all the time, as much as people try. The whole idea of if you want something done right, you have to do it yourself is like some kind of attempt at justifying this trait, but in reality, it often produces poor results when it's your main MO. Being able to delegate is actually a power move. Recognizing you can't do it all and asking for help not only brings higher quality results, but you can relax a little bit and share that sense of accomplishment with others. It's a win-win. Number 8. Your circle is toxic. And this goes both for work and personal life. We've said it so many times, you are the sum of the people you spend most of your time with. And if those people are toxic, they're burning you out and dragging you down. Like many of the points on this list, mindfulness is key. Take stock of the people you interact with the most in life and consider if they leave you feeling uplifted or dragged down. Examine those feelings and identify who you need to limit your exposure to. Set those boundaries we talked about earlier and free yourself from their grasp. If these people are in your workplace, speak to a supervisor to work out solutions to move desks or switch teams in order to drop the toxicity in your life. And if they don't support you in this, well, start planning your exit strategy. Number 9. You've got unclear expectations. Not many things are as stressful to a high achiever as not understanding what's expected of them. In a situation like this, it's important to lean into communication, even if it feels intimidating. So many kids go through school not raising their hand to ask questions or to gain clarity. And what good does that do in the long run? Literally nothing. Zero good things come from it. The only way to work out of this specific kind of work fog is to be very clear about what you need in order to feel comfortable in your role. Many times, the people in charge of you are unaware of how you're feeling. They're not mind readers. It's important to stand up for your own peace of mind and have the conversations that will get you what you need. You are your biggest advocate. Number 10. COVID languishing. All right, let's end this list with something none of us can really escape right now. We're far away from precedented times. And real talk, you're not alone. It's still messing with all of us. The New York Times came out with an article a few months ago that made everyone feel seen and gave us a name to put with all these weird feelings of emptiness, feeling stuck and a loss of focus. And that fancy little word is languishing, but it doesn't have to rule your life. COVID languishing is mostly spurred by feelings of uncertainty, and there's a lot of it going around. But the way to help yourself combat those feelings is by really narrowing your focus to things you can actually control, which is a pretty freeing exercise. Instead of letting your mind spiral into all those what-ifs and trying to plan for an uncertain future, take it all down to the basics and do things 1 week or even 1 day at a time if you have to. Focus on moving your body, making a good meal, even just sitting outside in nature. Give yourself 30 minutes a day to just breathe and do something simple for yourself. No pressure, just presence. Making that happen consistently goes a long ass way. And there you have it, Aluxers. 10 reasons you might be burning out right now and what to do about it. In the last couple of years, pretty much all of us have danced around with burnout. So we're curious, what's something you do for yourself to help manage it and stop it from ruling your life? Join the conversation and share your tips in the comments. You might just really help someone out. Now, before you go, here's that bonus I teased earlier. Not getting enough sleep. As much as this one can be a symptom of burnout, it can also be considered a cause. You don't need us to tell you how vital it is to get enough quality sleep. We all know the importance. But still, too many people sabotage themselves by not getting enough of it. And if this is you, we have a little hack for you to try. And I'm not joking, guys. I use this one myself, and damn, it works for me. It's called the 4-7-8 breathing technique, and it essentially tricks your brain and body into fully relaxing. So, when you're cozy in bed, ready for sleep, breathe in for 4 counts, hold that breath for 7 counts, and then breathe out for 8 counts. That's it. Just keep that rhythm going, focusing on breathing and counting until you fall asleep. It's been described as a natural tranquilizer for the nervous system, and for real, it can change your nighttime routine for the better. Test it out for yourself and let us know how it goes. Alright, we hope you gained some value in today's video, Aluxers. If you did, please like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon to never miss another video. We'll be back with another one tomorrow. See you then.